the DNA, genomic DNA is so huge. It's so huge. It is very high possibility that it will have these complementary sequence of these four. Hello everyone, welcome to Plutus IS. My name is Kushmeet Kaur and I will be taking your botany optional. The topic that we are going to study today is polymerase chain reaction. Okay, you can see that in the year 2012, one PYQ was asked from the same topic. The question was, what are primers and explain their role in PCR? Okay, so today we are going to cover about primers and PCR. See, PCR is the basic technique of molecular biology. Why? Because once you understand PCR, you will know about RT-PCR also and all the DNA based markers which are PCR based. Okay, so you really have to understand what is PCR first. So let's move forward and understand what is PCR. PCR is basically polymerase chain reaction. Okay, Carrie Mullis invented this reaction in the year 1985. And for this particular invention, he also got a Nobel Prize in the year 1993. Okay, so when I talk about polymerase chain reaction, as you can see the definition here, rapid and versatile method for amplifying defined target DNA sequences present within the source of DNA. What does it mean? For example, this is my DNA. Okay. And I wish that this is my DNA of interest. Okay, I only want copies of this particular DNA. See, so I can achieve that by this method. What is this method? Polymerase chain reaction. As the definition says, you can see, what does amplifying mean? Amplifying means producing copies of the DNA. Okay, producing copies. And what is target DNA? Target DNA means that this is the whole DNA, but I only want this much portion. So this is my target DNA. Okay. So this is all about polymerase chain reaction. Our goal is to achieve multiple copies of our target DNA. Okay. Now we will learn about the different components of PCR, starting with one of the most basic and important component, and that is, we just discussed, our target DNA. I told you that in the whole DNA sequence, the sequence which is my sequence of my interest, that is our target DNA, right? So this is my target DNA and it will produce two copies, and these two copies are of newly synthesized DNA. Okay, so these are my two copies of newly synthesized DNA. Now these two copies will further produce DNA, right? So now, when they will produce further copies of DNA, they will act as a target or template strand for the other DNA which has to be produced. Matlab, for example, this is my DNA. And my DNA kya kar raha hai? Do copies produce kar raha hai, right? Now, this will also produce copies further. So, ye now act karega as my target DNA or my template DNA. And further, my copies are produced. And similarly, now this will act as my target or template DNA. And it will further produce two copies. Because this reaction is happening in a chain process, in a regulatory process, that is why it is known as polymerase chain reaction. Okay, so this was the first component. Let's talk about others too. This is one of the most important component, that is PCR primers. Okay, what it is? It is a short sequence of DNA. Short sequence of DNA. How much short? It can be of, it should be of 20 nucleotide. The sequence should be of 20 nucleotide. Okay, that provides a starting point for DNA synthesis. Now what happens if I am separating two DNA strands? I wish that the primer gets attached to the complementary strand. What this primer will do? It will get attached to the complementary strand. So let us write it here. It will, what is the job of primer? It will bind to the complementary strand किसके complementary strand में of the target DNA. Okay, now you see here very carefully. Okay, now these two strands are separated. This is my 5 prime to 3 prime and this is my 3 prime to 5 prime. This strand is known as sense strand and this is anti-sense strand. You all know that, right? So now what will happen, where the primer will get attached? Primer will get attached or bind to the site where there is the free site, right? And this 3' has a free hydroxyl group. It has a free hydroxyl group. So the primer will come and get bind to the 3' site. So the movement of primer will be from 5' to 3'. Okay. Now you can see here are two strands. That means the primers are of two types. Which two types? Let's see. The two types of primers that we are going to study. Where should I write? I can write here. Okay. The first one is the forward primer and the other one is the reverse primer. Why so? The forward primer, one primer will come here. Look, one primer will bind here. Okay. And the other primer will come and it will bind here. 5, 3, 5, 3. So this primer is going to move in the forward direction, whereas this primer will move in the reverse direction. That is why this particular primer on the antisense strand is known as forward primer, and this one which is going in the reverse direction is known as the reverse primer. So two type of primers are what? Forward and reverse, because we have both strands and we have to synthesize both the strands. That is why on the antisense strand, forward primer will work because it attaches on the 3' hydroxyl group, and on the sense strand, reverse primer will work. Okay. So one important thing you can infer from here is that I said that primer bind to the complementary strand of target DNA, right? Iska matlab kya hua? This means I have to know prior that what is the sequence of the DNA target strand. Agar mujhe target strand ka sequence hi pata nahi hoga, how will these primers will go and attach? Okay. So one thing about PCR technique is that you should always know the prior sequence. You should have an idea about the prior sequence of the target strand. Then only we can design primers. And primers can go and attach to the sequence that we wish to amplify. Okay. Okay. So let's study about primer design, that how these primers are being designed, what criteria or what factors are considered while designing these primers. Okay. So the first one which I have wrote here is primer length. Okay. Now what we have to do with primer length? Okay, suppose the primer length is very short. For example, if the primer length is very short, let it be ATGC. I told you the ideal primer length is 20 nucleotide, 15 to 20 nucleotide. But if it is too short, this much, the DNA, genomic DNA is so huge. It's so huge. It is very high possibility that it will have these complementary sequence of these four. So what will happen? This will go and attach to multiple sites. Hai na? Matlab kya hoga? Jo DNA strand hai hamara, usme to bahut sare sequences hai na? Theek hai? Aur ye to bahut chota sa sequence hai. To probability ye dekhne ki ki aise complementary sequence kitne hi honge us DNA ke andar. So it will go and attach to multiple sites. So isse kya hoga? Ki jo hame desired apna DNA chahiye tha, jo mujhe desired sequence apna amplify karana tha, I will not be able to amplify that. Why? Because this will go and bind to multiple sites in DNA. Okay, that is why short primer sequence is not ideal. Okay, why? I can write it here for you. Because it will bind to multiple sites in the target DNA, and I will not get, or I can say, desired amplified sequence not achieved. Okay. Now what will happen if it is long? Is there any harm in being long? So imagine if the primer sequence is very long, then what could be the demerit of this? The demerit is that the rate of the reaction will be very slow. If the primer is very, very long, the rate of the reaction will be slower. So we don't want that. We don't want to waste our resources. So that is why if the primer length will be very long, that means it will slow down the rate of reaction. The rate of reaction will be slow. And we don't want that. That is why we told that the ideal length of the primer should be 15 to 20 nucleotides. Okay. Let us consider the second parameter, that is GC content. We all know what does DNA sequence have, ATGC. Okay. Now we are saying the GC content matters, how much it should be. The GC content should vary from 50 to 60 to 70%. Okay, this should be the range of the GC content, or we can write just 60% also. Okay, it should vary to 50 to 60% only. Why now, why this GC content is important? You know, in AT we have double bond, but in the case of GC, we have triple bond. Okay, and GC provides more stability. It provides more stability, right? So it will provide more stability to the primer. Okay, what is the relation of triple bond and the melting temperature? I will tell you when I will tell you about what, when I will tell you about the melting temperature, then I will discuss this. For now, you have to remember that in GC content, 50 to 60% GC in a primer would be preferred. Okay, why? Because the GC provides stability also. When there are GC sequences present at the primer end, we call it GC clamp also. Okay, this is extra which you can remember, that we call it GC clamp. What is GC clamp? When there is extra sequences at the end of the primer, so that is called as GC clamp. Okay, now the third criteria is the nature of sequence. Now what do you mean by the nature of sequence? That means, what if the primer has some sequences like this, G, G, A, here I have written T, 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 C. Now you can see in this sequence, what is absurd about this sequence, that this is complementary to this. This is complementary to this. How? G, A, A, T. Now we have T, T, C. So what will happen? This is 5 dash, this is 3 dash, sorry. This is 3 dash. What will happen as seen here, if you have complementary sequence within one primer, matlab ek hi primer hai, aur us primer ke andar hi ek dusre se complementary nucleotides present hai, to kya hoga? Wo DNA template ki jagah aapas mein hi bond bana lenge. As you can see here, that they have made bond within themselves. This is single primer. It was supposed to go and make bond with the template DNA, but it instead what it did, it made bond within themselves. And this type of structure is known as, hairpin loop. This is known as hairpin loop. Okay, so this type of thing should be avoided. That means while we are designing our primer, we should remember that it should not have inverted sequences or complementary sequences within the primer. Okay. Next and the last characteristic which is important is our melting temperature. What is melting temperature? We know melting temperature definition, but here the melting temperature is associated with what? I can write it here for you. Just wait. It is the temperature at which more than, or I can write just 50%, wait, at which 50% of the DNA has been converted to single strand. That means, you know, DNA has double strand, right? So this temperature is that temperature when the DNA, the half DNA, is finally converted into single stranded DNA. That temperature is known as the melting temperature. Okay, and it is denoted with TM. TM is what? TM is the melting temperature. Okay, we can also calculate this TM. How? I'll show you. So for the calculation of TM, we have one formula. Okay, the formula is 2 into A plus T plus 4 into G plus C, and all of this in degree Celsius. That means number of AT into 2 plus number of GC, total GC into 4, that will give you the TM. Okay? Let's try to calculate the TM of this primer by putting the values. Let's try it, okay? See, let me count the number of A and T. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the number of A and T is 10. Okay? This is a 20 nucleotide sequence. That means if AT is 10, then GC will also be 10. Okay? So 4 into 10 degree Celsius. 20 plus 40. That is 60 degree Celsius. That means the TM of this particular primer is 60 degree Celsius. Okay? Got it? Got the formula and how to crack it? Okay? I can, now you can ask me that what is this 2 and 4? Basically, this 2 and 4 are nothing but the dissociation energy. This 2 is the dissociation energy which is needed by A and T bond. And this 4 is the dissociation energy which is needed by this G and C. Okay? Okay. Now, let's talk about the third component, which is DNA polymerase. Which is DNA polymerase. DNA polymerase is required for the synthesis of the new DNA. Okay? Now the primer is attached. I will tell you step by step how it is done. You will get more clarity. But now we are concentrating on the components. Okay. So what is DNA polymerase? Basically, now the DNA, in the DNA, primer is attached. Now I wish to synthesize that DNA. I want to synthesize the new DNA. So for that, DNA polymerase helps in synthesis of new DNA. You can write it that way also. Synthesis of new DNA from template DNA. Okay. And DNA polymerase, which is used in PCR reaction, is taken from a thermos bacteria named as Thermus aquaticus. Okay. Why Thermus aquaticus? Because this bacteria is a thermobacteria. What are thermobacteria? You must have studied that in the paper 1, that thermobacteria or the bacteria which survive extreme hot conditions or cold conditions, such type of bacteria are known as archaebacteria, right? Archaebacteria, okay? So from this bacteria, what was isolated? TAC polymerase. TAC polymerase was isolated from this bacteria, and this TAC polymerase is a thermostable compound. It is a thermostable compound. Why thermostable compound? Because it can survive up to 90 degrees Celsius of temperature. And the optimum temperature for the working of TAC polymerase is 72 degrees Celsius. Okay, so why we have chosen TAC polymerase? Why not the polymerase present in human beings or E. coli? Because they are not that temperature tolerant. But this particular TAC polymerase, which has been isolated from Thermus aquaticus, is very thermostable compound because it can tolerate up to 90 degrees Celsius of temperature. And also the optimum temperature, this is the optimum temperature that is required by the TAC polymerase for its working. Okay. The activity of TAC polymerase is very, very good. Okay, it just do 1 in 9000 base pairs. So the error rate is very, very less. Okay, there is just one small thing where it lacks, and that is very important. You should always remember that is it lacks 5-3- exonuclease activity. You must have studied that in your transcription translation. That is, it is the proofreading activity, right? So it lacks that, okay? So we have an alternative for that, right? The alternative for TAC polymerase, I would write the alternative. Okay, the alternative is PFU. What is PFU polymerase? It has been isolated from Pyrococcus. Furiosus. This is the bacteria. This is also Archaebacteria, and this particular PFU polymerase has been isolated from Pyrococcus furiosus. Okay, so this is an alternative form of polymerase which is used in the PCR reaction. And the good part about this is that it has 5- to 3- exonuclease activity, which was lacking in what? Which was lacking in our थर्मस इक्वेटस बैक्टीरिया के पास जो नहीं थी टैक पॉलीमरेज के अंदर, वो एक्टिविटी किसके पास है? पीएफयू के पास है. ठीक है, सो इन डीएनए पॉलीमरेज वी स्टडीड दैट इट इज़ हेल्पिंग अस टू सिंथेसाइज द न्यू डीएनए. ओके, डीएनए पॉलीमरेज यूज इन पीसीआर इज टैक पॉलीमरेज विच इज आइसोलेटेड फ्रॉम थर्मस इक्वेटिकस. ओके, इट इज़ अ थर्मोस्टेबल बैक्टीरिया, आर्किबैक्टीरिया. And this particular enzyme is thermostable. It can tolerate up to 90 degrees Celsius of temperature. Its optimum activity is at 72 degrees Celsius. It also do just one error in 9000 base pairs. So it has good efficiency rate also. But the only problem with this is that it lacks the 5- to 3- exonuclease activity, which is done by PFU. Okay, but still, TAC polymerase is most commonly used. It is easily available. It is readily available, it is cost efficient. So rather than PFU, people always go for TAC polymerase, okay? Because the rate of the error is already very less, okay? So they are not really looking for the 5- to 3- exonuclease activity. But if you are going for a very specific experiment, you might need that, okay? But in common, TAC polymerase is preferred, okay? Now let's understand the fourth component, which is nucleotide DNTPs. What are nucleotides? DNTPs. DNTP stands for deoxynucleotide triphosphate. I will write it here for you. It is deoxynucleotide triphosphate. Okay. And it is of four types, just as we have our four nucleotides. Sorry, nitrogenous bases. Right? So it is DATPs, DTTPs, DGTPs and DCTPs. A stands for adenine, T stands for thymine, G stands for guanine and C stands for cytosine. So these are four types of DNTPs that are present and which help to synthesize the DNA. What are they are helping in? You will say primer was also helping. So primer is just a 20 nucleotide base pair of sequence, right? So we need more nucleotides to add in it, right? So these nucleotides are used to complete for synthesis of the complete strand of DNA. Okay? Now why I have written magnesium here? This magnesium not being the component, but it has a major role. Without it, we will not see the DNA bands. Why? Because this magnesium is a cofactor. It is a cofactor of a very important enzyme that we are using, which is TAC polymerase. That means for its activity, for the activity of TAC polymerase, magnesium is very, very necessary because it is its cofactor. So either we add magnesium separately or we can add magnesium within the buffer also. Okay, now let us understand the steps of PCR. Now you will have a broader picture of the components when you will study the steps. Okay, the steps of PCR, we have three steps here. The first step is denaturation. First you have two strands of DNA. First they will get separate. That step is known as denaturation. Okay, then we have primer annealing. Why primer annealing? Because with the help of primer they will come and they will bind here, and from here the DNA will be synthesized. So in this stage, in annealing, the primer will come here and it will bind to the DNA strands, both the DNA strands. Which primer? Forward primer and reverse primer. Okay, the third step is extension. Now the primer has been here on the DNA strand. Now it will extend and form the newly synthesized DNA. Okay, let us understand the steps one by one. The first step is the denaturation step. In this step, what will happen? See, this is your template strand, this is your target DNA. What will happen? Okay, now after denaturation, both these strands will get separate. Okay, these are the two strands and now they are separated from each other. Now you know what are these. These are bases. They are bonded together, hydrogen bonds, and some are double bond, some are triple bond, right? So in order to separate these strands, we have to give some kind of temperature. So a very high temperature of about 94 to 95 degrees Celsius, 94 degrees Celsius to 94.5 degrees Celsius is given for the DNA strands to separate from each other. So it is known as the denaturation temperature as well. So denature mein kya ho raha hai? Just the DNA strands separating from each other. That's it. Nothing else is happening. Okay. The second is annealing. Now what do we have? We have this one strand of DNA. We have this another strand of DNA. And now they have been separated from each other, right? I told you this is 5-3-3-5-. Okay, now what will happen in this stage? The primer will come and it will bind, hana? The forward primer will bind here and the reverse primer will bind here. 5-2-3-5-. This is my forward primer and this is my reverse primer. They will bind where? To the complementary DNA sequences. They will bind to the complementary sequences present in the DNA. Okay. Now, what would be the temperature of annealing? The annealing temperature is always, we prefer to keep the annealing temperature 5 degrees Celsius less than the melting temperature. I explained you TM. Okay. So annealing temperature will be 5 degrees Celsius less than from the melting temperature. For example, if my melting temperature is 40 degrees Celsius, then the annealing temperature would be 35 degrees Celsius. Okay. So what is annealing? In annealing, the primer is coming and it is binding to the complementary sequences present in the target DNA. Okay. I hope it's clear. Okay. The third and the last step is extension. Now what will happen? We have one DNA strand, the other DNA strand. We have seen in the last picture that the primer is also binded, right? The primer has been binded. Like for example, here the primer is binded and here the primers are binded, okay? Now what will happen? Nucleotides, DNTPs, I told you DNTPs, they will come and they will add and whole strand would be synthesized like this. Okay, here also the strand will be synthesized. Okay, so in the extension step, the DNTPs will add and synthesize the DNA. That means at the end, we will get two copies of DNA. Okay, in which this is my parent DNA and these are my newly synthesized DNA. Okay. एक्सटेंशन में क्या होगा? प्राइमर जुड़ चुका था, अब बेसेस आएंगे, नाइट्रोजनस बेसेस, डीएनटीपीज आएंगे और वो भी जुड़ जाएंगे साथ-साथ और पूरा का पूरा स्ट्रैंड जो है वो बन जाएगा, ठीक है? तो दिस इज द साइकिल ऑफ पीसीआर. सो साइकिल ऑफ पीसीआर, व्हाट विल हैपन? वी कैन हैव मल्टीपल साइकल्स ऑफ पीसीआर एज वेल. ओके, आई शोड यू वन साइकिल हियर. द वन साइकिल ऑफ पीसीआर इज कंप्लीटेड. I can have many cycles of PCR. For example, if I am having 4 cycles of PCR and I want to know 4, or I can write it here 2 also. Suppose I have 2 cycles of PCR. Okay, now I want to know that after 2 cycles of PCR, how much copies of DNA has been produced. Okay, so I have a formula for that here for you. This is the formula. In this, MI is what? It is the number of template DNA taken. Generally, one is taken. We take one DNA as the template DNA. Okay, what is 2N? 2 is digit, and N is what? N is number of cycles. N is number of cycles. So here I took the example that 2 cycles. So the MF, or the number of copies which have been produced, is 1 into, sorry, this is not plus, this is into. 1 into 2 raised to the power N. What is N? N is 2. So it will be 2, 2, that is 4. That means by the end of the 2 cycles, I will have 4 copies of DNA. Okay, is that clear? If I run 20 cycles, then I will receive 10 to the power 6. That is 1 million copies of DNA. If I run 30 cycles, I will get 1 billion copies of DNA. So imagine, just by running this cycle, it is just a matter of 3 to 4 hours. Okay, so when I run these cycles, I get this much copy of DNA. So look how efficient is this technique, right? This is a thermal cycler. What is a thermal cycler? I'll tell you. See, this is the instrument in which PCR is performed. First we take tubes and we put all the components in the small microtubes. Then we keep the tubes here. From here we set the temperature and if the cycle, the amount of the DNA present, everything. And in this thermal cycler, the temperature is run for 3-4 hours according to the temperature and the product, the timing is decided. Okay, so this was about cycle. So here I have shown you one cycle also. Okay, let us understand that very quickly. So, and we will also revise. The first step was what? The first step was denaturation, right? So denaturation, I will write it denaturation for you. Denaturation mein kya ho raha tha? DNA ki strands separate ho rahe the ek dusre se, right? And the temperature which was required was 94 degree Celsius. Okay, why I have written 2 times 94 degree Celsius? So what happens is that first it is kept on 94 degrees Celsius for 2-3 minutes, then again for 1 minute. Why? Because we want to make sure that all the strands of DNA has been separated. Kuch reh na gaya ho. Isiliye do baar matlab wo time hi set karte hain, apne aap hota rehta hai, theek hai? To 94 degrees Celsius pe 2 se 3 minute rakhte hain hum, theek hai? Uske baad kya aaya drop by temperature mein? Kya ho raha hai yahan pe? Annealing ho rahi hai. Annealing mein kya hota hai? Annealing mein primer jo hai wo bind karta hai, right? Primer will bind, okay? Primer will bind in annealing, and the temperature in the required for annealing is, I told you, 5 degrees Celsius less than which? Less than the TM. TM se 5 kam. TM se 5 degrees Celsius kam temperature kiska hoga? Annealing ka hoga. Achha. Now can you tell me the third step is extension, right? In this extension, the temperature is generally kept 72 degrees Celsius. Can you guess why? I told you that in extension, what is happening? Synthesis of DNA is happening. Aur isko kara kaun raha hai synthesis ko? I told you in the starting, one of the most important component, TAC polymerase. Who is making it? TAC polymerase. And I also told you that TAC polymerase has its optimum activity at what temperature? At 72 degrees Celsius. That is why we keep the temperature of extension as 72 degrees Celsius, so that the TAC polymerase can perform optimum, at its optimum. Okay, that is why extension temperature is kept at 72 degrees Celsius. What is this? This is, we generally kept at 12 degrees Celsius for infinity. Why? After the cycles are run, after everything is done, we don't want ki ekdam se temperature drop ho jaye. ठीक है, तो क्या करते हैं हम? प्रोडक्ट को होल्ड कर लेते हैं 12 डिग्री सेल्सियस पे. ठीक है, So it is the cooling temperature basically in which the product is hold for some time so that ऐसा ना हो कि temperature complete होने में एकदम से temperature बाहर निकाल दिया, बाहर 40 degree Celsius है, बिल्कुल सारे product का ऐसी तैसी हो गई, तो ये नहीं करना है हमें, ठीक है? तो हमें क्या करना है, हमें उसको product को hold कराना है, इसलिए हम 12 degree Celsius पे for infinity रख देते हैं ताकि जैसे हमारा experiment over हो तो वो हमारा product जो है वो safely 12 degree Celsius पे पड़ा रहे जब तक उसको हम निकाल नहीं लेते, ठीक है? So this was a cycle, denaturation, क्या हो रहा है? DNA अलग हो रहा है, annealing primer जुड़ रहा है, extension primer तो जुड़ा हुआ है और पूरा DNA का synthesize जो strand है वो synthesize हो रहा है और ये cycle हम बार बार repeat कर सकते हैं और जितनी बार हम repeat करेंगे उसके according हमारा PCR का time set होगा, ठीक है? I really hope PCR is clear to you, right? All the temperatures is important, everything, every enzyme is important, TAC polymerase, magnesium which is a cofactor for TAC polymerase, every step is important, okay? So let's understand the advantages and limitations. Advantages is high sensitivity. What is high sensitivity? That with a small amount of target DNA, we are able to produce millions of copy, right? So that is why the PCR is highly sensitive, okay? Quickly perform in 4 to 8 hours. ऐसा नहीं है कि हमें पूरा दिन लगता है, कभी कभी वेस्टर्न ब्लॉटिंग जैसी टेक्निक्स में पूरा दिन लग जाता है, ठीक है? लेकिन PCR को हम 4 to 8 hours में कर लेते हैं. In fact, I have done it in 3 hours also. Okay? Cost effective why? Because these products are comparatively cheap. We can afford them, so it is fine. Okay? The last is increased ability to detect less common organism. अगर दो ऑर्गेनिज्म बहुत क्लोजली रिलेटेड नहीं है, मतलब बहुत क्लोजली सिमिलर नहीं है, तो उनको हम डिफ्रेंशिएट कर सकते हैं बाय यूजिंग PCR, ओके? देन द लिमिटेशंस, व्हाट आर द लिमिटेशंस? लोअर स्पेसिफिसिटी. आई टोल्ड यू कि अगर बहुत क्लोजली नहीं है तो हम डिफ्रेंशिएट कर सकते हैं, इसका मतलब कि अगर बहुत क्लोज हुआ तो इट विल बी डिफिकल्ट, ओके? तो बहुत ज़्यादा स्पेसिफिसिटी नहीं है इसके अंदर, ठीक है? This point I told you while teaching that the prior information of the sequence is needed. अगर हमें DNA template का sequence ही पता नहीं होगा तो हम कैसे उसके primer design करेंगे, कैसे primer लगाएंगे उसमें, right? So that means that the prior information of sequence is required. ऐसा नहीं है कि मैंने कोई product ले लिया, मुझे sequence नहीं पता और कुछ भी डाल दिया उसके बीच में, नहीं. I have to know the prior sequence. So that is a limitation. Okay? PCR product is limited. All the components of PCR that we have studied till now is exhausted while we are performing PCR. जितने भी products हैं सब exhaust हो जाएंगे except what? Except magnesium which is the cofactor, which is the enzyme. It will not get exhausted. Otherwise all the products will be get exhausted. Okay, the last point. Product size range is limited. That is 0.1525 kb. Let us understand the last topic which is applications of PCR. Why scientists do PCR, where it is applicable, okay? For research purposes, of course, it is applicable. Other than that, DNA cloning. So what happens? We take the amount of target DNA, we amplify it, and then we can use that amplified DNA for cloning purposes also, okay? The second point is forensics. Forensics mein kahan pe? Forensics mein very, very important branch, DNA fingerprinting. We will learn about DNA fingerprinting also in further classes. It was also the question asked in the PYQs. So DNA fingerprinting is one of the most important application of PCR or determination of parents. In that also PCR can be used. And disease diagnosis, disease such as HIV also could be diagnosed by the help of PCR. So this PCR technique is very efficient as it can amplify from a small amount of DNA to multiple copies of DNA, and we are using that multiple copies of DNA for our own applications. So it is a gem and a great discovery by Carrie Millis. So I hope that you are you have understood the topic, and in the next class we will learn about RT-PCR and molecular markers also. Okay, thank you.